Hello and good morning. I am Professor A.V. Brahmane. Today we are going to see the second article of unit number 6. The name of the article is Particle Swarm Optimization. Friend, if you remember, we have already learned the introduction to the swarm intelligence. Swarm intelligence is the technique which is inspired by biological science. So it is one of the component of evolutionary computing methods. Now, very important part of this swarm intelligence is the optimization algorithm. With the help of this optimization algorithm, we are trying to optimize the candidate solution so that it can give the better result. So very popular and widely used algorithm is particle swarm optimization and ant colony optimization algorithm are the part of your syllabus. Today, we are going to learn the first algorithm, particle swarm optimization. The content of this presentation are introduction and background. Then how the PSO algorithm works, the basic PSO algorithm, particle swarm optimizer, application of PSO, real life scenario of PSO, and flowchart of PSO algorithm. Friend, as an introduction of PSO, in computational science, particle swarm optimization is a computational method that optimizes a problem by iteratively trying to improve a candidate solution with regard to given measure of quality. It solves a problem by having a population of candidate solution, here dubbed particles, and moving this particle around the search space according to simple mathematical formula over the particle's position and velocity. Each particle's movement is influenced by its local best known position, but is also guided toward the best known position in the search space, which are updated as a better position are found by other particle. This is expected to move the swarm towards best solution. PSO is the meta heuristic as it makes few or no assumption about the problem being optimized and can search very large space of candidate solution. However, meta heuristics such as PSO do not guarantee an optimal solution is ever found. Also, PSO does not use the gradient of problem being optimized, which means PSO does not require that optimization problem be differentiable as is required by classical optimization method such as gradient descendant and quasi-Newton methods. PSO is originally attributed to Kennedy and Eberhard and was first intended for simulating social behavior as a stylized representation of the movement of organism in bird flock and fish school. The algorithm was simplified and it was observed to be performing optimization. Now let's see how this PSO work. So here, a basic variant of PSO algorithm works by having population called swarm of a candidate solution. This is called as particles. These particles are moved around in the search space according to few simple formula. The movement of the particles are guided by their own best known position in the search space as well as the entire swarm best position. When improved positions are being discovered, this will then come to guide the movement of the swarm. The process is replaced and by doing so, it is hope but not guarantee that the satisfactory solution will be eventually discovered. Formally, let a cost function is defined as r raised to n tends to r, and this must be a minimized function. The function takes a candidate solution as an argument in the form of vector of real number and produce the real number as an output, which indicate the objective function value of the given candidate solution. The gradient of f is not known. The goal is to find a solution A for which f of A less than or equal to f of B for all B in the search space, which would be A is the global minimum. Let S be the number of particle in the SWAM, each having a position xi belongs to r raised to n in the search space and a velocity vi belongs to r raised to n. Let pi be the best known position of the particle I and let g be the best known position of the entire SWAM. This slide shows you how this algorithm works. First stage, for each particle I, which is equal to 1 to s, do initialize the particle position with uniformly distributed random vector. Initialize the particle based on position to its initial position. Update the SWAM based on position. Initialize the particle velocity. While a termination criteria is not met, then you can repeat the following stages. These stages you can repeat. Still, the termination criteria is not met. Update the particle velocity. Update the particle position. If f of xi less than f of pi, then update the particle based known position. If f of pi less than f of gi, then update the SWAM based known position. Now, particle SWAM optimizer, what are its advantages? The advantages of the PSO are incentive to scaling of design variable, simple implementation, easily parallelized for concurrent processing, derivative free, very few algorithm parameters, very efficient global search algorithm. Disadvantages of PSO that slow convergence in refined search stage, weak local search ability. What are the applications of PSO? So training of neural network, identification of Parkinson's disease, extractions of rules from fuzzy networks, image recognition, optimization of electric power distribution, structural optimization, optimal shape and sizing design, topology optimization, process biochemistry, system identification in biomechanics. Friend, now see what are the real life example or real life scenario of this particle SWAM optimization. As initially I already cleared, these SWAM intelligence and PSO are inspired by nature. So these are inspired or motivated by bio-inspired concept of this natures. So see, PSO inspired by social behavior of the bird flocking and fish schooling. Suppose a group of birds is searching food in the area. Only one piece of food is available. Bird do not have any knowledge about the location of the food, but they know how far the food is from their present location. So, what is the best strategy to locate the food? The best strategy is to follow the bird nearest to the food. Now you can see in this slide, the current position of the bird, a flying bird has a position and a velocity at any time t. In search of food, the bird changes his position by adjusting the velocity. The velocity changes based on his past experience and also the feedback received from his neighbor. On the right hand side, you can see the next position of the bird. This searching process can be artificially simulated for solving non-linear optimization problem. So this is population-based stochastic optimization technique inspired by social behavior of the bird flocking or fish schooling. Each solution is considered as a bird called particle. All particles have the fitness value. The fitness value can be calculated using objective function. All the particles preserve their individual best performance. They also know the best performance of their group. They adjust their velocity considering their best performance and also considering the best performance of best particle. Now you can see the PSO algorithm flow diagram. This slide can give you the better view of the flow chart of the PSO. Here, initialize the particle. Second step is calculate the fitness value of each particle. Is the current fitness value better than the previous? If yes, then assign the current fitness as a new p-based. And if the current fitness value is not better than p-based, then keep the previous b-based. Next stage, assign the best particle p-based value to g-based. Calculate the velocity for each particle. Use each particle's velocity value to update its data value. Target or maximum epoch reached. If you feel that now we reach to the maximum stages, then you can stop. Otherwise, you can repeat this process for getting a good result or optimized result. So this is the flowchart of particle swam optimization. Friend, I hope that this presentation or this video lecture will help you to understand the particle swam optimization. So this is the optimization algorithm used in soft computing or swam intelligence for getting the good result or optimized result. Thank you very much.